Good morning to everyone. So in last class we discussed about DC characteristics of operational amplifier, and in previous classes we started the characteristics of operational amplifier. We are very familiar now at this condition, we are very familiar with the characteristics of operational amplifier. Okay, so we discussed the characteristics of operational amplifier like open loop voltage gain, input resistance, input resistance or input impedance, output impedance, offset voltages, offset current, slew rate, and common mode rejection ratio in general features. So in later we discussed about the features like AC characteristics. In AC characteristics, we discussed about frequency response characteristics. We discussed about slew rate. We discussed about stability, and we discussed the power supply rejection ratio and everything. So next we discussed about DC characteristics of operational amplifier. In the discussion of DC characteristics of operational amplifier, what we studied means we discussed about input biasing currents. That means how the DC characteristics happening in an operational amplifier. Okay, there is a condition here in DC characteristics. What happens means when the input terminals, non-inverting input terminal and inverting terminal are both are grounded. That means V input 1, V input are 0. Because of the biasing currents, there is an output voltage creating in the V naught end that creates some error. Okay, serious error. Okay, so we discussed about the behavior of input biasing currents in DC characteristics. We discussed about input offset voltages. We discussed about input offset currents. We discussed about output offset voltages, and we discussed about the behavior of temperature effect. That means the what is the main objective of temperature effect means if the operational amplifier operates beyond room temperature, the performance of the operational amplifier will get be affected. That is what we discussed up to the previous classes. So with respect to our up to now we discussed knowledge, that is with respect to our prerequisite knowledge. Okay, so we discussed about compensation techniques before. In today's class we are discussing about frequency compensation techniques. So in last class we discussed about DC characteristics compensation. So how can we compensate or how can we eliminate DC characteristics? So now in today's class, we will discuss about frequency compensation techniques. So what are the various frequency compensation techniques means? So frequency compensation techniques. So frequency compensation techniques are two types of classified into two types of discussion. One is external compensation techniques, and second one is internal compensation technique or Miller compensation techniques. Okay. So in this external compensation techniques is explained with respect to two types. What is dominant pole compensation and second one is pole zero compensation. That means external compensation technique is classified into two types, dominant pole classification and pole zero classification. Okay. So what is the necessity of this frequency compensation techniques, or what is the main objective of this frequency compensation techniques? We will see now. So we already discussed about frequency response in AC characteristics. In AC characteristics, we discussed about the behavior of frequency response. So that means what is the behavior of frequency response and what actually happens in frequency response, we discussed in the AC characteristics. That means here in AC characteristics of operational amplifier, we discussed the frequency response. That means what is the purpose of frequency response means. So in order to describe the objective of frequency compensation techniques, here we already studied about frequency response characteristics. Frequency response characteristics. That means we analyzed the frequency response characteristics in this discussion. We observed the frequency response with the variation of gain and with respect to magnitude and its phase angle. That means the variation of gain with respect to magnitude and phase angle in change with the frequency. So here the gain function is complex. So here the gain function is complex and AC characteristics. So we analyzed the gain response characteristic and as well as gain response characteristics as well as phase response characteristics in a particular operating frequency. So if we see the equivalent circuit, we explained and we discussed about this frequency equivalent circuit before. We discussed about this equivalent circuit before. So this equivalent circuit is having inverting input terminal and non-inverting input terminal. Inverting input terminal and non-inverting input terminal, and this is the input resistance. Okay, this is the internal circuit. Okay, this in vertical triangle, inside the vertical triangle we have the internal circuit, we know that. So this is the internal resistance and this is the AOL. AOL is nothing but open loop gain of the operational amplifier, and V2 is nothing but with respect to output voltage, and R0 is nothing but output resistance, and C is nothing but internal capacitance of the operational amplifier. Okay, so from this circuit, so what we did means we analyzed a gain formula. We calculated and we analyzed the gain formula. See very careful, here we have a single capacitor. So in this operational amplifier, this single capacitor will play a major role. So due to the capacitance effect of the single capacitor, so we will discuss about the corner frequency. Okay, due to the single capacitor, we will observe what will be the corner frequency. Corner frequency is also known as breakout frequency. We discussed this concept before. We again recall those prerequisite knowledge, and next we will explain the behavior of frequency compensation. Okay, so from this equivalent circuit, from this described equivalent circuit, so we derived gain formula before. That is, capital A is nothing but gain. We represented in the equivalent circuit, gain of an operational amplifier, A is represented here. Gain is equal to gain, capital A is equal to AOL, open loop gain with respect to 1 plus J into operating frequency with respect to corner frequency. So this gain we represented, or this gain we derived before, is nothing but gain for an simple operational amplifier. So if we observe the magnitude here, the magnitude of gain is equal to AOL divided by square root of 1 plus F divided by F1 whole square. Okay, so whereas F is nothing but normal frequency, operating frequency, and F1 is nothing but corner frequency or breakout frequency. F1 is caused due to the effect of capacitance, which is placed in the internal circuit. Okay, so if we see the phase angle phi, that is equal to tan inverse of operating frequency with respect to crossover frequency or breaking frequency. That means if we observe the phase angle response of our operational amplifier, the magnitude will be like this. That means if the frequency is go on increasing, the magnitude is constant. Here the magnitude, even though the frequency is go on increasing at every time, with the gain magnitude with respect to time characteristic, this is the phase angle with respect to time characteristics. That means if the frequencies go on increased up to a particular frequency range, the magnitude is constant. That means after some frequency range, the gain amplitude is started decaying with a frequency at a corner frequency of 3 decibels, 3 decibels less than the operating frequency. So from this magnitude of response curve, we can operate the operational amplifier from 0 to F1. Beyond this F1 value, if we operate with the greater of frequency F1, the cost, we can operate the frequency beyond the F1, the gain value will be like this. The gain value is started dropping. That is, the system does not provide a constant response. The response is oscillating. If you vary the frequency beyond F1 value, the phase magnitude is also around 45 degrees. See here, in the phase magnitude, it is 45 degrees. Up to 45 degrees, it is okay. But we operate beyond frequency F1, beyond F1 value, the phase value is varying from, we know that the phase value is varying from 0 to 45 degrees. After F1 frequency, the phase value is decreased like this. This analysis of one corner frequency we have seen in operating with respect to, so this entire discussion, this entire thing is happening because of one capacitor is placed with respect to the output circuit. One capacitor is placed with respect to output circuit. See, there is one capacitor placed here at the output circuit. So this entire things, this entire thing is happened because of this output capacitor, which is placed in the output terminals of the operational amplifier. But in practical operational amplifier, so in this equivalent circuit, we have shown only one capacitor. But in practical operational amplifier, what actually happens means we have number of capacitors. That means we have interlinked capacitors. So these interlinked capacitors, due to their stray fields or due to the PN junction layers, so we have number of internal capacitors. This number of capacitors will produce number of corner frequencies. That means this F1 is the corner frequency. This F1 is the corner frequency is due to single capacitor. So if we see the response characteristics here, F1. Okay, this F1 is nothing but corner frequency due to single capacitor. So in practical, we have number of operational amplifiers which are connected, and we have numerous number of internal capacitors, and these internal capacitors, number of internal capacitors will create a stray capacitance effect. So and this stray capacitance effect will produce number of corner frequencies, number of corner frequencies. So if we refer how the corner frequency is created, means see here. So if there is a, if we are having number of capacitors, so in the above equivalent circuit, what we said in the above equivalent circuit, we have shown only one capacitor is connected to the output. But in practical operational amplifiers, what happens means we have number of capacitors which are connected with respect to the output terminals, and that number of internal capacitors will cause a stray effect, and that causes more number of corner frequencies. So here we can see here we have different corner frequencies, number of corner frequencies we can see here, F1, F2, F3. That means the response is delayed if the operational amplifier is operated beyond the operational frequency range. The response is delayed to 20 decibel. From one frequency range to another frequency range. See, from one frequency range to another frequency range, the response is delayed. That means here the frequency response is flat is around 90 decibel. Total frequency range is around 90 decibel. Here we can see. Okay. So the first breakover frequency range is happened at 200 kilohertz. First breakover frequency, and next after the second breakover frequency is happened at 2 megahertz. That means in between F1 and F2, the gain drops from 90 decibels. 90 decibels minus 20 decibels. So here the new operating gain is around 70 decibels. And after that at F3 at 12 mega ohms, and again it is dropped to another 20 decibels, that is at 40 decibels. The new operating gain is at 40 decibels. And again later it is dropped to again 20 more, and that is 60 decibels. That means, so if we operate the frequency, if we operate the circuit with the number of output capacitors, if the innumerous number of output capacitors are present at the output, there will be an existence of breakover frequencies or corner frequencies. So here corner frequency is also called as breakover frequency. Okay. What causes the breakover frequency means the stray capacitance. Because of the capacitance effect, this breakover frequency will happen, and there used to be a deviation in our gain response. Okay. So the response is delayed to 20 decibels. This is the response with respect to open loop gain with respect to frequency curve. We discussed this. So the response is delayed to 20 decibels from one frequency range to another frequency range. So if we observe the voltage transfer function, if we observe the voltage transfer function from this expression, if we observe the voltage transfer function from this expression, so voltage transfer function, we already derived that from the gain. We already defined the gain parameter in the above discussion. The gain value AOL is equal to gain value A is equal to open loop gain plus divided by 1 plus J into operating frequency divided by corner frequency. F1 is corner frequency or breakover frequency. So from that we are taking that gain value capital A, and frequency is represented with respect to the domain omega. Okay, domain omega, that is equal to, we're replacing F with omega, that is capital A is equal to AOL divided by 1 plus J into omega by omega 1. Okay, so from that capital A is equal to, so if we again simplify this expression, so we will write like this. We will take the denominator multiplied with, we will take an LCM in the denominator. So A is equal to open loop gain into omega 1 divided by omega 1 plus j omega. So here j omega is nothing but our S domain. So if we represent it with respect to S domain and omegas, overall gain value capital A is equal to AOL into omega 1 by S plus omega 1. Okay. So this entire discussion of voltage transfer function is limited for single breakover frequency. That means this is for a single RC circuit. See, this is for this single RC circuit. This is our, this entire discussion up to now we discussed the voltage transfer function is discussed about for single RC network, which is internally connected in operational amplifier. But what happens in real or in practical operational amplifiers? In real and in practical operational amplifier, we have number of stages. We have number of stages of outputs, a series number of stages of outputs, and each stage we have an RC pole pair. They must cause a numerous number of breakover or corner frequency. That means if we see the transfer function operated at a three output stage. So let us see here. So this is for single stage we discussed above. So if the operational amplifier is operating at a three stage, that means if the practical or real operational amplifier at each and every stage we have capacitance component. That means in each and every stage we have RC pair, so that at each and every stage we have capacitance component, and this cause a breakover frequency or corner frequency. That means the transfer function can be obtained for three different breakover frequencies. That is capital A is equal to AOL divided by 1 plus J into F by F1 into 1 plus J into F divided by F2 plus 1 plus J into F divided by F3. That means here the corner frequency is, here we have three corner frequencies. This is a three stage operational amplifier. So we have three stages. Here we have three RC pole pairs. At each and every pair we have an capacitive component, and at each and every pair of the capacitive component we have a breakover frequency. Each breakover frequency at three stages represented at F1, F2, F3. Okay, so the corner frequency terms is represented with respect to, F is represented with respect to omega. If the F is represented with respect to omega, means so the entire thing will be different. And if we simplify that, the capital gain value is equal to AOL into open loop gain into omega 1 into omega 2 into omega 3 divided by 1 S plus omega 1 into S plus omega 2 plus S plus omega 3. That means here the gain response will be like this if we operate with three operating frequencies at three stages. So if we see this particular figure, the gain response will be operated at three different frequencies. F1 is one different frequency, F2 is one different frequency, F3 is one different frequency. At three different frequencies, the gain function, so actual operating gain function is 90 decibel,
The gain function is decayed. The gain function is decayed with 20 decibels at each increase of frequency. The frequency is increased from F1, that is at 120 kilohertz. At 200 kilohertz. This F1 is at 200 kilohertz, and next that is at 2 megahertz. F2 is at 2 megahertz. 90 decibels is dropped to 70 decibels, and again it is dropped to 40 decibels. That means the gain function is decayed at 20 decibels. That means we can't get a constant output response. See, we can't get a constant output response if we increase the frequency beyond the operating frequency. That means only we can get the constant output response from 0 to F1. Okay, the output is constant from 0 to F1. We can't get the output response beyond that. The output goes on oscillating by increasing the frequency. If we increase the frequency. So we have to eliminate this effect of corner frequency. Okay, we have to eliminate this effect of corner frequency. We have to maintain a constant gain behavior. We have to maintain a constant gain. So we have number of corner frequencies and breakover frequencies in our operational amplifier. So what is our main objective is here now, we have to eliminate the breakover frequencies by using a compensation technique. So see the stability. If we observe the behavior of stability, in this stability condition, what happens means, so how can we, operational amplifier is having very high gain. We in order to improve the stability, we connected a negative feedback. This is negative feedback is connected, negative feedback terminal is connected to the inverting terminal of negative inverting terminal of our operational amplifier. And this is that closed loop. And this is having certain, this feedback loop is having certain gain value B. We already had this discussion. So what will be the total gain value of the operational amplifier? If we connect the feedback, total loop gain of operational amplifier, that is A divided by 1 plus AB. That means here, if we take the transfer function, A divided by 1 plus AB, where the pole of the section, 1 plus AB is the pole of the section, if the 1 plus AB is 0, at that condition, AB is equal to minus 1. That means if the denominator is equal to 0, 1 plus AB is equal to 0, then AB is equal to minus 1. We can't produce, at that condition, what happens means if AB is equal to minus 1, AB is equal to minus 1, the gain value will be infinite. We have to eliminate the infinite gain value. If the gain value is infinite, the stability will be, the stability of the system will be very, very poor. To eliminate the gain value, what we'll do means we can do 1 plus AB is equal to 0. That is 1 minus of minus AB. We can write that expression 1 plus AB into 1 minus of minus AB to eliminate the infinite high gain. At that condition, what will happen means minus AB is equal to 1. That means the magnitude of this particular condition is equal to 1. And this particular phase angle of magnitude AB is equal to 180 degrees. That means the system is said to be stable. If we get a fixed response in a desired time period, that means we can get a fixed response in a proper desired time period. That means if we maintain the value of mod AB, magnitude of AB is equal to 1 and a phase angle of 180 degrees, we can obtain a desired response, desired constant response. So that is our main objective. What is our main problem? See here, if we see the role of rate of change in this characteristics, we are not getting the desired constant response. Our gain value is dropping to 20 decibels. If we operate beyond the operating frequency, if we change the corner frequency from F1 to F2, the gain value is getting dropped. That's why in order to maintain the desired constant response, what we are doing means we are taking the gain magnitude value as 1 and phase angle magnitude phase
condition at 180 degrees. So the desired response is obtained at a constant behavior for a finite time of duration. So to maintain this condition and to maintain stability, we are going for frequency compensation scheme. That means in order to maintain stability, in order to maintain a constant gain, or in order to maintain a constant gain magnitude curve, we are proposing a frequency compensation curve, frequency compensation techniques. So the first compensation technique is external compensation technique. That is, external compensation technique, we have two types. One is dominant pole compensation and pole zero compensation. So this is very, very important. Okay. So in dominant pole compensation, we are designing an additional pole in our system. We are designing an additional pole in the system, which causes an elimination of corner frequency. So see here. So this is our gain value, which is derived from our frequency response characteristics. That is capital is equal to AOL divided by 1 plus J into F divided by F1, 1 plus J into F divided by F2, 1 plus J into F divided by F3. This is a three-stage system. That's why we have three breakover frequencies. And again, if we replace F with the omega, the entire expression will be like this. So see here, this is how we compensate the network. See, this is the RC pole pair we are talking in the above. This is the RC pole pair. So this is a single RC pole pair, which is connected at the output terminal. See here, this is the input terminal to the inverting. This is our operational amplifier. Operational amplifier is fed with an input. Right, correct. Some posted a question. Operational amplifier will have two inputs, but in symbolical manner, in schematic manner, right? Your question is correct. Operational amplifier will have two input terminals. One is inverting input terminal and non-inverting terminal. So in a symbolic representation, so in order to explain this dominant pole compensation, I am explaining this entire input terminals as one. I'm taking that as one. Okay. So this is V input terminal that is fed as an input to the operational amplifier. And at the output segment, I connected an RC pole pair. So at the particular RC pole pair, we connected at the output of the operational amplifier. This additional RC pole pair will affect upon the denominator of the transfer function. Okay. This RC pole pair will affect the denominator of the operational amplifier. The dominant pole means the pole with magnitude smaller than the existing pole. Okay. So here we said dominant pole compensation. What is meant by the term dominant pole compensation? This dominant pole compensation means, so we are adding an additional pole. We are adding an additional pole with magnitude smaller than the existing pole. So our main aim is to maintain a constant frequency. So if we take the transfer function, if we again derive the transfer function at this particular output. Okay. So this is the output of the operational amplifier. We connected the RC pole pair here. We can take the output here. So what is the output at this condition? If we take the output at this condition, what will be the output of the gain value? Gain value output is equal to V naught divided by V naught dash. Okay. V naught is the output of the RC pole pair. See, very carefully see here. V naught is the output of the operational amplifier. And V naught dash is the output of the RC pole pair, and V naught dash is the output of the operational amplifier. Okay, right. We are calculating the value of gain. A1 is equal to V naught divided by V naught dash. V naught is the output of the RC pole pair with respect to V naught dash is the output of the operational amplifier. We already got this type of discussion in frequency response. Okay, that is minus JXC1 divided by R1 plus JXC1. We already got the discussion. And there also we replaced XC1 that is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC1. Here we substituted here. Okay, and if we simplified that value, and if we replace FD is equal to 1 by 2 pi F into R1 with respect to C1. If we substitute that FD here, A1 is equal to 1 by J into F divided by FD. Okay, So what is the value of FD? FD is called as dominant frequency component. FD is called as the new component here we observed. See, FD is called as dominant frequency component. So now we calculated gain A1. Okay, A1 gain is calculated where this A1 gain is existed. The A1 gain is existed here. A1 gain is existed in the RC pole pair. A1 gain is existed in the RC pole pair. If we calculate the overall gain, if we calculate the overall gain of this particular operational amplifier, if we calculate the overall gain, capital A overall gain, if we calculate the overall gain, A dash is equal to V output with respect to V input. Okay. V output, that is V naught, total output divided by V naught dash is the output of the operational amplifier, and V naught dash with respect to output of operational amplifier with respect to input. Okay. So A dash is equal to A1 into A. Okay. We know the value of A here. Total gain of the operational amplifier capital A is equal to AOL. So we already got this discussion from here. Okay. So this is the operational amplifier gain when it is operated at three stages. So we got the total gain of the operational amplifier, and we got the gain at individual RC pole pair. Okay. So if we multiplied both of them, A dash is equal to, A dash is equal to, that is equal to AOL divided by, so this is, we replaced the omega 1 value with the F by F1. Again, omega 1 is equal to F by F1, omega 2 is equal to F by F2, omega 3 is equal to F by F3. Okay, we replaced that and we represented, we multiplied A dash is equal to A1 into, yeah, we multiplied both of them, and this is the new component value, this is the new gain. So if we observe the new gain value where A is the initial gain of the operational amplifier, A dash is the additional gain of the RC network. Okay. A dash is the additional gain of the RC network, single RC pair here. A is the gain of the operational amplifier and A dash is the gain of the RC network. Okay. So here see in the actual figure, what we got, the A dash. So here we have four poles. See, S plus omega D, S plus omega 1, S plus omega 2, and S plus omega 3. So here we have four poles. That means here S plus omega D is added. So this is the initial gain, and this is the initial gain of operational amplifier, and this is the actual, this is non new calculated gain. That means here the dominant pole we are adding, the dominant pole technique we are adding, that means we are adding an additional pole which is dominating our operational amplifier. See, the omega D is nothing but the additional dominant pole which will affect the entire operational amplifier behavior. That means S plus omega D we are placing with the help of the RC pole pair which is connected in the output of the operational amplifier. Okay, so we are adding S plus omega D. After adding S plus omega D, that means after adding the dominant pole, see, the gain value is delayed through. So this is the uncompensated. See here. So this is the uncompensated value before. So previously what happened in our discussion? Previously, after the operating frequency what happened? The gain value is dropped at particular, the gain value is dropped after the compensation. The gain value is dropped here. So what actually happens means here the gain value is dropped. So now we compensated that. We added the dominant pole pair S plus omega D in our output of the operational amplifier technique. So the gain value is delayed through 20 decibels. Okay, in the main frequency, the gain value is delayed to 20 decibels. Without compensation, the operating frequency, after operating frequency F1, there is a dominant pole and that is dropped. that is dropped after operating frequency f1, there is a drop with respect to the gain value. There is a drop with respect to gain value. So after compensation, what happens? After compensation, a new frequency is existed here. See, this is f suffix d. This is the dominant frequency. So here we have a constant compensated drop. A constant compensated drop. That means here, with the help of compensation, f suffix d, it is compensated. It is compensated. So see here, this is the FD. At FD frequency, the dominant frequency, the gain value is dropped to 20 decibels, and this is the compensated line. Okay, so without compensation, we can see that the operating frequency is F1. At F1, after the compensation, without compensation, the operating frequency is F1. After the compensation, the operating frequency is F suffix D. But what actually happens means the bandwidth. Okay, initial bandwidth is BW1 here, but later the bandwidth is dropped through to BW2. Later the bandwidth is dropped to BW2. This is the main disadvantage. The bandwidth range is decreased by the dominant pole technique. See, previously this is the range of bandwidth, and later this is the bandwidth is dropped through BW2. The latter, the bandwidth is dropped to BW2. That means in order to eliminate this thing, we are proposing a new concept that is called as pole compensation technique. So what is the main merit of the dominant pole means, by creating an additional dominant pole S plus omega D, there is an excellent noise immunity system. That means at this small bandwidth, the complete noise, the operational amplifier is exercising a behavior of noise rejection. The operational amplifier can have the behavior of noise immunity. Noise immunity. So what happens means with respect to the next merit is, by adjusting the frequency at FD, the gain margin and the stability of the system is assured. Okay, so after the compensating, the gain margin and the system is assured. So if we see the particular compensation and uncompensated, if there is a difference in compensation and uncompensation, that means after selecting the FD value, the gain magnitude plot is passed through the zero decibel and pole is around F1 to A. And that after the F1, that means at compensation, there is a severe drop, and this is the compensated with respect to dominant pole. What is the main drawback? The main advantage is the noise rejection capability is improved. Excellent noise immunity we got, but what is the main drawback is there is a drop with respect to bandwidth. There is a drop with respect to bandwidth, and that can be achieved. This disadvantage, the bandwidth is drastically reduced in this compensation system. This can be achieved with pole compensation method. So what is pole compensation method? Okay, so see here also we have three Baco frequencies, and this is our gain value. And we replace the F1 value, F1 gain, the value of gain, F1 is equal to omega. Sorry, F is equal to omega. We replaced F is equal to omega, and we represented the new gain value here. So this is the actual gain formula. So see the figure. So we are placing an additional resistance. That means the operational amplifier is having an actual gain A. In addition to the RC circuit, we are adding an additional resistance R1. So with respect to this additional resistance R1, if we calculate the behavior of gain capital A1, to this particular new RC pole pair, so what will be the value of Z1? Z1 is equal to R1, and Z2 is equal to R2 minus JX into C2. Okay, so R1 is nothing but impedance. R1 is represented as impedance Z1, and the entire series circuit, RC series circuit, R2 minus JX into C2 is represented as Z2. So what will be the gain parameter with respect to voltage divider rule? That is Z1 divided by Z1 plus Z2, as per AB parallel, that is A divided by A plus B. So similarly, voltage divider rule, A1 is equal to Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. So therefore, what happens means the value of A1 is equal to, so if we replace the value of Z2 with respect to the term R2 minus JX2 and Z1 with R1 and Z2 with R2, we replace the impedances with respect to resistances and capacitances. So this is the actual gain value, actual gain value at A1. Okay, if we simplify further, we know that XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. We replaced that 2 pi FC here. Okay, we know that 1 by 2 F1 is equal to 1 by 2 pi F1, and F0 is equal to 1 by 2 pi F into R2 C2. We know that from the traditional expressions. We replaced and simplified again. So this is the new gain value. A1 is equal to 1 plus J into F divided by F1 divided by 1 plus J into F divided by F0. Okay. So from this expression, so we calculated the gain at the pole zero compensation method. So this is the gain value of the RC circuit. This is the gain value of the RC circuit, which is added to the output of our operational amplifier. So what happens to the overall gain value? If we see the overall gain value, so this is the behavior of overall gain value. See the overall gain value. Overall gain is represented with A dash. That is equal to A1 into A. That is equal to overall gain that is represented, that is A1 into A. Okay, this is the value of capital A here we got. This is the value of capital A we got here. This is the value of capital A we got here. Okay, and we know the value of A1. What is the value of A1? The value of A1 is equal to 1 plus J into 1 plus J into F divided by F1 divided by 1 plus J into F divided by F0. Okay. So this is the value. So if we substitute both of them, if we multiply A into A1, A dash value will be A0 into this numerator. This numerator will be multiplied, and this denominator and this denominator will be multiplied, and this A1 value is our this is the new gain value. A1 is the new gain value of pole zero compensation. A1 is the new gain value of pole zero compensation. So how can we see, means if we explain with the new gain value, so how this new gain value is efficient means, so see here, with respect to the new gain value, here the numerator zero, one plus numerator zero component, 1 plus J into F divided by F1 is cancelled with respect to the second pole, 1 plus J into F divided by F1. This will be cancelled. So that means the additional zero value cancelled with respect to the existing zero value. Okay. So the frequency response value will be improved. The frequency response value will be improved. How can we improve means, if we see the rate of roll of change characteristics. So see this figure. So this is the uncompensated. This first, this decayed value is the uncompensated value. That means in uncompensated value beyond F1, if we operate the operation value beyond F1, that is dropped. And in uncompensation value, the gain value is decayed again with respect to 20 decibels. Again with respect to 20 decibels. Okay. But what actually happens here? After compensation with respect to pole zero method, after compensation, F0 is nothing but pole zero compensation method. So if we increase beyond, if we use the pole compensation method from frequency F0 to F2, see, from if we use the pole compensation method from frequency F0 to F2, the gain value, the main value is maintained as a constant slope. This is very, very important. This is the difference with respect to dominant pole method and pole zero method. Okay, the gain frequency is constant in this region. the region of gain, the ratio of gain to frequency is constant like this, is constant like this. This is how we can create a constant response output with our operational amplifier. That means the response is improved by adding Powell and zero at the output of the operational amplifier when compared to an initial operational amplifier. Okay, so when compared to dominant pole method and pole zero compensation method, the behavior is improved. Okay, the behavior is improved with respect to the pole zero method, and we here we can see a constant slope, and the behavior of bandwidth is also improved. The bandwidth is also very very high, and the, there is an improvement in the bandwidth when compared to dominant pole component, dominant pole compensation method. Dominant pole compensation method. So in second, in next class we will discuss internal compensation method, and this is also called as Miller compensation method.